All right, so welcome to the second demonstration of this desk lamp model. In the first video, we made the desk lamp shade, and then we also attached the spine. In this part, we're going to make an on and off switch on the top of this, and then we're going to add in a base at the bottom, and then we'll make a few tweaks here and there if it deems necessary. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is go to the top portion of this, zoom on in. We're going to delete these corresponding faces, and then we're going to extrude from that to make that switch. All right, before you do anything, make sure you don't have any extra edge loops, so go to your vertices, average vertices, and sure enough, we have an extra edge loop, so that would have been pretty bad. Now, one of the things I had to compromise on this top piece was adding in that shape to attach the spine. Now, unfortunately, I have a few extra edge loops that I probably don't need, but for the sake of expediency, I'm just gonna go ahead and delete them. And I'm sure it will compromise the shape of it and the topography, but that's something I'm not really worried about. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead, select these edges, go to vertices, and then average them out, and then maybe bring them in just a tad bit, because we wanna make sure that button is fairly big and noticeable. And then we'll bring that in to make sure that circular shape stays in place, and there you go. Okay, and then I'll just go ahead and soften this edge up a bit. And there we go. Maybe just get these a little bit one more time. Soften that edge, and there we go. Okay. Extrude thickness, we want about maybe 150, just to make it sure it's noticeable. Make sure you go from a far distance. Make sure you're satisfied with how it looks, and I think that looks okay. So we'll zoom back in on here. Select these edges, extrude again, then thickness, offset. It's a little bit too big, so we'll go 0.50. And that looks pretty good. Okay, so there's our on and off switch. It looks a little rough on the edges, so we can soften those up by beveling. One of the things I noticed about Maya is that there's an algorithm flaw that when you ever try to tweak the bevel with a segment, it makes the faces transparent. I'm not sure on how to get around this. I think it's either reverse propagate or reverse the normals, but I don't know, for some reason it's just not doing it. So for the time being, I'm just going to add it in manually. So add it in like this, and there you go. Same with the bottom. Go ahead, bevel that piece right there, and then if you want, you can add in another edge loop right there, but I don't think it's necessary. All right, and then we'll close that up later. Back for now, I'll just close this up. Extrude edge, or we can just close it up, fill hole, and there you go. Okay. Now we're going to add in the base at the bottom portion right here. Same thing, we're just going to extrude. And then always make sure, let me hide this real quick, and there, always make sure that you have a deleted face right here, that it's not closed, otherwise you're going to run into some problems later on. Okay, so we're just going to deselect all that. Extrude thickness, let's go about maybe 0.1. It's a little bit too small, so let's try 1. Okay, extrude again. Thickness, let's try 0.350. Negative 0.350. It's not working for me right now. You know, one of the things that you have to get used to with Maya is that sometimes it'll work with you, other times it doesn't want to do that. So negative 0.350. There we go. All right. So now what we'll go ahead and do is try figuring out what we can add in with our base mod with our base. Now, one of the things I've noticed, one of the things I can probably add before I extruding was making a piece out of here that could act as a connector without it seeming like you extruded one piece from another and then it doesn't look correct. So, I mean, just looking at it from this angle, yeah, it doesn't seem like it's connected to anything. So what we could do is redo this, select these faces, and we'll extrude them out, and we'll give them an offset. Or what we could do is bevel that to about maybe 0.5 or 0.4, depending on what you want to go with. Maybe try 3. That looks okay. And then what we can do is extrude the rest of it from here. So we'll thicken it out to, let's say, 1. Scale these to about 0.5, and extrude them out again. This down, to about 0.3. It looks a little bit small, so I might go ahead and make this maybe 4 or 5. You have to make sure that the base isn't too small. And then we'll just play around with the thickness. 0.4 seems to be like a good spot. Instead of 5, let's do 4.5. So we remember we don't want to make this too big, but we also want to make sure it adheres to it. Okay, bring this down one more time. I know I'm going back and forth with tweaking it, but I'm just trying to make sure it looks correct. All right, that looks fine. Okay, so now what we have here is by adding this connector piece, it now gives it a little bit more of a realistic look as opposed to just extruding it from one cylindrical piece. So, and that's usually what you see on most of, on some of the desk lamps is that there's a connector piece to it before it attaches to the surface of the base. All right, so now I'll just go ahead and start tweaking some stuff. And then connect this, select all these. Sometimes you might have some extra faces, so it won't allow for you to connect it. There we go. Bevel that. Not working yet, so let's go ahead and figure out what we are having problems with. There we go. I don't know, for some reason you'll run into this issue where it doesn't select all of the edges. So just delete them and then just extrude them again. So we'll just bring these out one more time. Extrude thickness. And then just again carefully or reattach them. So just go to each one and then just move them into place. It's tedious work, but if you're striving to improve, you will get used to it and come to understand why it's necessary. Okay, that should be it. Go back into our shaded view, exit out of there, and there we go. Okay, so now let's bevel that. There we go. Okay, and then we'll just add in an edge loop to this side right here. There we go. Okay, same thing. Probably delete these as well, since that probably had to be compromised. Let's extrude these edges. Thickness, go down to about 0.4. Select them again. There we go. Okay. And then just go ahead and add in some edge loops. There we go. I know I'm not doing a lot of talking here, but usually it's just a matter of tweaking and following along. All right, so now our base is nearly complete, but there is some things that I am noticing is that we have some rough edges over here, like you can tell. Now, what you could do for a temporary fix is take all of this, all the edges, and soften them up. And then it gives you a little bit more of a rounder shape, but you still can do a little bit more with it. You can take each of these edges and just soften them up. So if you want to take this, deselect that, you can do that. Otherwise, from this angle, it looks pretty good, and so on and so forth. Well, that's really all we have left to do. And then maybe if for an extra bonus, we can take the edge of the outer piece and extrude inward to give it some thickness. 0.50. There we go. All right. So there's the on and off switch, and there's the base. So I guess in the next video, we will continue on adding improvements. Thank you.